Today's February 9th, 2024. I'm Christine Niles. It's our debut episode of Catholic News Roundup, bringing you the world's top stories from a Catholic perspective. Something I hope to do on a regular basis, and I'd love to hear from you, your feedback or news tips or any stories you'd like to see covered. Just write me at stellamarismedia@proton.me. First up, President Biden is mentally incompetent to stand trial. This from the DOJ. Special Counsel Robert Hur said Biden is a, quote, elderly man with a poor memory, close quote, who would be sympathetic to a jury. It's the reason the DOJ is choosing not to prosecute Biden for wrongfully keeping classified documents in his garage. Hur's report notes that Biden failed to recall when he was vice president, when his term ended, when his term began, and the date of his son's death, among other memory lapses. Political commentators are questioning Biden's fitness for presidency, including GOP House Speaker Mike Johnson. The president's press conference this evening further confirmed on live television what the special counsel report outlined. He is not fit to be president. Senator Ted Cruz tweeted, "Truly astonishing, the U.S. Department of Justice formally laying out evidence that the sitting president of the United States is not competent to stand trial. He cannot remember when he was vice president, but this man has the nuclear codes." Even left-wing outfit CNN is weighing in, slamming Biden's performance in his Thursday night address, where he confused Egypt's president with Mexico's.
I don't know why he went back out. He already said most of this at, in Virginia today, but this is becoming a five-alarm fire for the White House.
Mexico? Where did that come from? I mean, that's the only thing anyone's going to remember from this.
Meanwhile, people are noticing the contrast between Biden's performance and that of Vladimir Putin. In a wide-ranging interview aired Thursday night on X, the Russian president spoke with Tucker Carlson about Russia's long history, world politics, and religion. Catholic commentator Matt Walsh tweeted, "Tonight, as Putin gave intelligent, scholarly answers that delved into 1,000 years of Russian history, President Biden was babbling incoherently about how the president of Egypt is actually the president of Mexico." In the interview, Putin claimed the West has repeatedly sabotaged Russia's attempts to negotiate peace.
So I just want to make sure I'm not misunderstanding what you're saying. I don't think that I am. I think you're saying you want a negotiated settlement to what's happening in Ukraine.
Right. And we made it. We prepared a huge document in Istanbul that was initialed by the head of the Ukrainian delegation. He affixed his signature to some of the provisions, not to all of it. He put his signature and then he himself said, "We were ready to sign it and the war would have been over long ago, 18 months ago." However, Prime Minister Johnson came, talked us out of it, and we missed that chance.
Elsewhere, Putin confirmed the U.S. government is actually run by the deep state.
So twice you've described U.S. presidents making decisions and then being undercut by their agency heads. So it sounds like you're describing a system that's not run by the people who are elected in your telling.
That's right.
Others are blasting Tucker Carlson for being the mouthpiece of a propagandist, with member of European Parliament Guy Verhofstadt, former Belgian prime minister, saying, quote, "As Putin is a war criminal and the EU sanctions all who assist him in that effort, it seems logical that the External Action Service examine his case as well." As of this taping, the interview has gained more than 100 million views in less than 24 hours. Pro-family leaders are warning against a massive government power grab. On Monday, pro-family groups and congressmen met in Washington, D.C. to urge rejection of the World Health Organization's pandemic treaty. Among them, Reggie Littlejohn, to warn against coming digital IDs.
But if you look on the World Economic Forum website, there's a chart about what you're going to have a digital ID to do, which is access healthcare, travel, have a bank account, shop online, pay your taxes, vote. Basically, these digital IDs, once installed, are going to control every aspect of everybody's life.
The Vatican's doctrine chief is blaming ultra-conservatives for misusing his book. In recent comments to OSV News, Cardinal Victor Manuel Fernandez said, quote, I regret that the ultra-conservative sectors that do not accept me have used this book and have spread it widely. He's responding to concerns from sex abuse victims disturbed by the contents of his book, Mystical Passion, which contains graphic language about sex mixed with spirituality.
He hasn't expressed any remorse for it. He's gaslighting. All he said is that he pulled it for fear of being misinterpreted. Now, my words, the rest of you crazy Catholics are going to be overly sensitive and you're going to take it the wrong way. There's nothing to be misinterpreted about this book. He never should have written it in the first place. You know, he says, oh, I wouldn't write it today. He never should have written it. And the fact that he seems so preoccupied in an unhealthy way with things of a sexual nature is really concerning.
A hit podcast about demonic warfare is launching a crowdfunding campaign. The Exorcist Files, which has garnered more than 5 million downloads, is raising money for season 2. Producer and exorcist Father Carlos Martins wrote on Facebook, we decided to go independent with the show to gain more creative control over content and to control the kind of advertisers who affiliate with us. The podcast is based on Father Martin's actual case files, sprinkled with solid Catholic catechesis. Supporters can donate by going to Kickstarter.com and looking up Exorcist Files. And as a note, we've interviewed Father Martins twice on Forward Boldly. Please check out our archives to find those interviews. The Vatican is telling clergy to stick to the script. In a note released February 3rd, the Dicastery for the Doctrine of the Faith reminded priests of the importance of using the prescribed formula for sacraments like baptism and the Eucharist. Clergy are using formulas like, I baptize you in the name of the Creator, or I baptize you in the name of Mama and Papa, rendering the sacrament invalid. This follows on the heels of a scandal in Detroit, where a priest discovered he had never been validly baptized, making his own sacrament of ordination invalid, leading to thousands of invalid baptisms, holy communions, and confessions. Argentina's Catholic president will soon be meeting with the Argentine Pope. Conservative firebrand Javier Milei is in Rome this weekend, first meeting with Italy's prime minister before attending the canonization of Mama Antula, Argentina's first female saint. On Monday, he'll have a private audience with the Pope. Milei wrangled leftists everywhere after recently giving a fiery speech in Davos, blasting socialism and government control.
You are social benefactors. You're heroes. You're the creators of the most extraordinary period of prosperity we've ever seen. Let no one tell you that your ambition is immoral. If you make money, it's because you offer a better product at a better price, thereby contributing to general well-being. Do not surrender to the advance of the state. The state is not the solution. The state is the problem itself. You are the true protagonists of this story.
That's today's Catholic News Roundup. I'm Christine Niles. If you haven't signed up for our emails, please go to stellamaris.media and sign up to get the latest news, updates, and episodes. And remember to send me any news tips or stories you would like to see covered. Simply write me at stellamarismedia@proton.me. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon.